Imagine, you walk into a busy room. People look at you, they stop talking. Some start to whisper or laugh quietly. How would you feel? Would you feel judged? For me, that's almost a daily experience when I'm walking outside with my youngest son. People look at him, then they look at me, asking questions. I have one of those, living in the street. My colleague, she also has one. They're always so happy. Must be hard for you, having a child like that. They're always so stubborn, they eat so much. And I remember, just 2 days after he was born, I was at the hospital. There was a lady coming up to me. She smiled at me and then she looked into the pram and she said, "Oh, I'm sorry. My son has Down syndrome." I've learned how to deal with all the judgments, but I will never get used to it. People acting like they know my son, knowing exactly what he can do and especially what he cannot do. It's hard to see the boy behind the labels. Before he was born, I was scared. I too had some preconceived ideas. To be honest, I never talked to a person with Down syndrome, thinking we would not be able to connect, to interact with each other. So I thought having a child with Down syndrome would be a heavy burden for us as a family, for me as a person. We would not be able to play soccer together, to communicate together, to make jokes together. But none of that turned out to be true. But these experiences, they inspired me to start working at a foundation called Strong Together Without Stigmas. This foundation raises awareness of the stigmatizing of people with mental health issues. I met lots of people while working there. Lots of people who felt stigmatized because of their diagnosis. People who feel ashamed of who they are. People who are afraid to start a relationship or find a job or join a sports team. People feeling lonely and isolated. I met a woman. She has a depression and she feels misunderstood. Every time she tells about her depression, people telling her, "Well, go out for the weekend, get some good nights of sleep and all will be better." But it's like the same as telling a soccer player who just broke his leg that after a hot cup of tea, he can play again the second half. This woman, she feels more hurt about all the judgments than about her depression. I know a man who deals with psychosis. What are your first thoughts about a psychosis? That this man is dangerous, that he's crazy, maybe he's delusional. He's a teacher. He's a teacher and sometimes he's sick dealing with psychosis. But he is a father, he's a great family man, and he's a brilliant mind. But his colleagues, they don't know what to say to him. They don't talk about his diagnosis. Parents, they question if he ever can be a good teacher. Lots of people dealing with those judgments. It makes young people drop out at school. It makes people not trying to find a job or leaving that job. But change is possible. Change is possible if we are aware that we all do it. We stigmatize people because of their diagnosis. Let's realize that a diagnosis doesn't define a human. At most, it describes some of his or her personal struggles or personality. Let's stop judging each other. When I first heard about the diagnosis of my son, Victor, my world collapsed. But I know better now. I see a young boy full of life, playing soccer, having fun, making jokes. And he loves to interact with people. And he doesn't judge. He doesn't judge at all. He walks to every person who wants to meet him. Smiles at them, waves at them. No judgment, just connection. Yes, it's hard sometimes to have a child with an extra chromosome. Victor, he has inspired me with the freedom that lack of judgment brings. He makes me a better person. Just to reach out openly, to see people without judgment. And I hope Victor can be an inspiration for you as well, to stop judging and to start connecting.